Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_019_BIAB_I where you save it. You can also download this file on the website. Go and click the file tab, hover the mouse cursor to save as, and select project. Rename this file to 00_020_BIAB_I and click the save button. Select this wall. Hold down the control key, click this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall. Click the down arrow and select my external wall generally 6 inches. Click to deselect. Select this internal wall. Hold down the control key. Select this wall, this wall, this wall. Select this wall, this wall, this wall, and click the down arrow to my internal wall generic 6 inches. Press escape. Now select the portion of this wall and change the top constraint back to roof. Press escape to deselect the wall. Go to the quick access tool and select the match property command. Select this wall and this wall. Press escape. Now go to the project browser, double click the first floor plan to open that view. Select this wall and click the flip arrow. This wall, flip arrow. Click change the view detail to fine. Go to the modify tab, modify panel, and select the split elements button. Split this wall, select the trim extend to corner, select this wall and this wall. Click the trim extend single element, select the face of this wall and extend this wall. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the match property, select this wall and match it to this wall. Click the modify button, select this wall and click the flip arrow. Now we also need to flip some of the beam, but because of the view range we cannot see the beam on this view. Click the modify button to make sure that nothing is selected in the project. Go to the property palette and click the view range. Now change the top offset to 10 feet and change the cut plan to 9 feet 6. This way we will see the beam, and later we change it back to the normal. Now our beam, the beams are visible. Select this beam and flip outside. Select this beam. Click the 3D view to see the results. Go to the view range again. Change this back to 7 feet 6 and the cut plan. Change it to 5 feet. Click OK. Double click the roof plan. Select the roof. Click the sunglasses. Hide category. Select this articles to see to click and orient them in the right direction. Make sure that all of them orient in the right direction. Click the sunglasses and select Reset temporal height, isolate object. Close this view. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Select this article. Hold down the control key, select the beam, the cable, the beam. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select this. Click the down arrow. Move them to my external wall generic 6 inches. Click OK. Select this beam in the modify wall panel. Select the chart top base and select the slab. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to make sure that everything is in order. Go to the ground floor plan. Change the view range to click the edit button next to the view range. Change this value to 10 feet and change this value to 9 feet 6. click OK, select the slab, click the down arrow and select height category. Select this wall to see that it orients outside. Select this wall, this wall. Select this wall, click to orient it outside. Select this, and select this. Now, click the modify button to make sure that nothing is selected and go to the view range again by clicking the edit button. Change this to 7 feet 6 and change this to 5 feet. Click OK. Click the sunglass and select reset temporal height isolate. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Now select this wall. We're going to use another command to flip this wall into the right direction. Click the mirror pick axis command and uncheck the copy option. Click at the midpoint of this wall. Click the modify button to see the results. Now the wall is being mirrored into the right orientation. Select this wall, click edit type, click duplicate. You can give whatever name you want to give. I just want it to be different from others. I'm going to call this E generic wall. Click OK. Click edit. Insert. Select this. Move up. Select this. Move down. Now I'm going to click this material and change to the gypsum board wall. Click OK. Copy this and paste it here and change the value to 1/2 inch by deleting the double quote space 1-2. Click in this input, delete the double quote space 1/2. Click OK. Click OK. Click out to see the results. Now double click the ground floor plan to go to the ground floor plan view. Go to the trim split elements command and split this wall. Go to the trim extend to corner, select this wall, press escape, select this wall, click the down arrow and select the E generic 6 inches. Select the trim extend to multiple elements. Select the face of this wall to extend this wall and extend this wall. Go to the 3D view to see the result. Now you see the in and out of this wall have the same color. Press escape to get out of the command. In fact, I'm going to change this wall to the generic model. To do that, select this generic model and click edit in place. Now click on this mask and select edit extrusion. Go to the front elevation, the right elevation. Double click the right elevation to open that elevation. Click the pick line button, pick this line and select the trim extend to corner. Click this and this, click this and this. Select the split elements tool to split this sketch line. Select the trim extend to corner. Click on this and this. Click on this sketch line. Zoom in and click on this sketch line. Click on this sketch line. Zoom to click on this sketch line. Click on this sketch line. Zoom and click on this sketch line. Click the split elements. Split this sketch line. This sketch line. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line. This sketch line. This sketch line. This sketch line. Click the align command. Zoom in and align to the external face of this wall. You can consider this extra wall as the plastering. And click the sketch line. Lock it into that face. Zoom in and click on this external face, the plastering. Zoom in and align the sketch line. Lock the sketch line. Do the same thing over here. Align this Now select the multiple option, select this face, align this, lock, click on this, lock, click outside to break the multiple alignment, select this face, click the modify button, start the align command again, select the multiple option, click on this face, and select this sketch line, lock, select the sketch line, lock, click the green check mark, click to finish, go to the 3D view to see the results. Now select the conceptual mask, click the sun class and select hide category. Select this wall, hit delete on your keyboard, select this, hold down the control key, select this wall, hit delete on your keyboard, select this wall, hit delete on your keyboard, click on the sun class and select reset temporal hide isolate object. Now to correct this problem, let's edit this roof, select the roof and select click edit extrusion. Go to the first floor plan, zoom out closely, zoom in closely, select the align command, select, uncheck the multiple option, select this face and select the sketch line, click the green check mark, go to the 3D view to see the result. Select this wall, click the chart to base and select this roof. Go to the roof plan, select the extend single element, click the face of this roof and extend this wall, click the face of this roof and extend this wall. Go to the default 3D view, click the modify button, select this wall, attach top base and select this roof. Press escape, hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit to see the results. Now select this mask in place, click edit in place, in the grid panel select extrusion, click the set work plan, click the pick button, click OK, hover the mouse cursor to the face of this concrete and click the pick line button, click the face of this and the face of this wall, the face of this wall, the face of this wall. Use the draw line button, go to the right elevation, click the draw line button, draw a line from this point and move down, press escape, start a line from this point, move down, press escape, go to the align, go to align dimension command, select the face of this wall and click on this, move the mouse down to position dimension and click the EQ button, repeat the same process, select this sketch line, move down, click the EQ button, press escape, now select the pick line button and change the offset to 1 foot 6, zoom in close, offset this to the right and to the left, offset to the right and to the left, change your offset to 0, click this face, press escape, select the split element tool, split this sketch line, select the trim extend to corner, trim this, press escape, select the dimension and hit delete on your keyboard, select this sketch line, hold down the control key and select this sketch line, hit delete on your keyboard, select trim extend to corner, trim this and this, press escape, go to the 3D view and click the green check mark to see the results. Now go to the footing plan, footing view, zoom into C, select the measure between two points reference, click at the face of this foundation to the face of the attic wall. The distance is 1 foot 1.5. Now, then measure the distance from this foundation to the mass is 1.5. Now select the mass and change the extrusion to 2 feet. Go to the default 3D view and click the green check mark. Now go to the foundation plan and select my basic foundation 8 inches. Go to the edit properties, edit, and change the material to gypsum board. Change this material to gypsum board. Click on this feed and select the concrete cast in place. For the cut pattern, scroll down and select the, you can select whatever pattern that you want to select. For this exercise, for the purpose of this exercise, I'm going to select the diagonal box and click OK. Click OK. Click OK. Click OK. Click the 3D view to see the result. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. Select this column and select this column. This column. Click the modify button. Click the vertex on this view cube and click the save button on the quick access toolbar. Alright, we'll continue to edit the wall in this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we'll continue to model the conceptual mass to build the front windows. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to us. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial on in or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.